Hi, I hope y'all are having an awesome day, and today we're going to be unboxing and reviewing the Pikachu-themed Uni Kuru Toga Mechanical Pencil. So without further ado, let's open this up. So obviously we have these Pikachu illustrations on the sides here, and obviously this Japanese lettering that I cannot read, and this little, illustration that shows how this lead mechanism rotates, but we'll expand on that later. But let's open this up. Obviously, super easy, like all mechanical pencils that we unbox on this channel. You just slide it out. And let's take this pencil out. And obviously, you can see that there's this little Pikachu illustration on the pencil that they printed. It's actually kind of cool. I like how the two Pokeballs are stacked on his head. He looks like confused. It says Pikachu right here in kind of a cursive looking font. It says number 25, which I believe is his Pokemon number. And oh, okay, so like most mechanical pencils, it's preloaded with lead. Pretty smooth, right? Give us about a week and we'll be right back to give y'all a full review. See ya.
1 week later.
Okay, so as always on this channel, we went over this pen for about a week, and I have a few quick things to point out here before we rate it. First of all, the obvious main selling point of this pencil is the lead rotating system here in the barrel. It has a clear acrylic body so you can see inside of it, and if you press on the lead, and whenever the lead makes contact with the paper, this orange part spins. And it's really cool that you can see that with this white logo they included. Sorry if you can't see it because of the lighting, but this part is rotating, and it makes it so you're always writing with the sharp side of the lead instead of always having to flip the lead, so you're writing on just a sharp side. So it makes it so you don't write with dull lead. This does have kind of a downside with this acrylic part because it's hard, and it makes it kind of uncomfortable to write with long distances of time. Although this is not really labeled as an ergonomic pencil, so I can kind of let it slide, and it does have this orange band here. Finally, just as a last point before we jump into rating this pencil, I would like to point out that like most higher priced mechanical pencils, this one opens up at the top. Sorry, my hands are sweaty, but it opens up at the top, and obviously I've used this eraser enough. And if you actually run out of the eraser, it's kind of impossible to load the lead up, other than from over here, but that's harder. But you can see this like tiny lead capacity. I can kind of let it slide because of this obviously big lead rotating system and also having to make it look good at the same time. But it's kind of a downfall of the pencil, and I just wanted to point it out. Let's put this back and jump into reviewing it. As always, this will consist of three main points: comfort, usability, and value for money. Value for money will be displayed up here as VFM, and that's just a side note for people that don't know what VFM stands for. For comfort, I'm going to give this pen a kind of average 7 out of 10 because of the hard plastic instead of a rubber grip, but it does have a nice little orange band, like I mentioned before, which actually does provide a bit of comfort instead of just having a rock hard, like, grip. Next up, usability. I'm going to give it an 8 out of 10 just because of the small lead capacity. I'm not going to take that out because my hands are still sweaty. But it doesn't really allow you to use it for long periods of time, but the lead rotating system does sort of cancel that out because of its ability to make the most out of every stick of lead. Lastly, this pen offers, in my opinion, a great value for money. And I'm gonna give it a 9 out of 10 just because it has a few minor downsides, but it looks really cool. Definitely something I would bring to class and show off, but I do like this pen a lot. And in conclusion, this pen gets a 24 out of 30 rating, which actually translates to an 8 out of 10. So most people are more familiar with the 10. Oh, sorry, y'all can't see what I'm writing. The 10 rating system. So this is what it is in 10s, and this is what it is in 30s. But that is my review of this pencil. Thank you for watching. As always, don't forget to hit the like button if you enjoyed this video, and subscribe if you really want to see more content like this. Any pen suggestions that you think I should review next would be much appreciated, and I'll see you next time. Bye!